I think for many students, the first time they step onto the beach at Bamfield, it can be a life-changing look at the algae. So the beaches there have far more algae growing on them, many different species compared to here, and for many of them it's the first time they've been exposed to that sort of an environment.
In the lab or in the classroom, we were maybe exposed to a handful of species on slides or in a tank, and when we went to Bamfield we got to see hundreds of species laid out on the beach where they would naturally be found. So we get to pick at them and take them back to the lab and look at them and just see what they look like in the natural environment, where they're found together, and it just gave us a chance to really see the natural diversity that we were studying from a hands-on perspective.
In a lab or a lecture from the slideshows and stuff, those learning materials give me a very restricted area of what I'm actually learning. But when I went to Bamfield, for example, the beach walk that we had to go on, I saw a whole bunch of diverse algae just living in their natural habitat, and those real natural environment based learning is what actually impacted on my learning in algae courses.
Bamfield's great because the things that attract students there also attract the researchers there. So great facilities for doing research, great support for getting out into the field, and so it's a unique mix of new learners, young students, undergraduates, graduate students, and professors all really want to be there.
It's hard to study a rainforest without being in a rainforest. And when you're in a rainforest, you really get a sense for, well, first of all, it's wet and it's dark and the trees are huge. And it just supports an amount of biodiversity that you could never replicate in a lab. Or even closer to home where it's less pristine. Bamfield is completely secluded, untouched by people. So there's still old growth there, trees that are 800 years old that support their own ecosystems with symbiotic relationships between lichen and algae and fungus that you can actually study in the forest. So it's a different perspective. It's not so much the marine perspective, but the terrestrial one.
So one of my favorite stories from working with some younger students at Bamfield was we had brought up some subtidal organisms by dredging along the bottom, and we brought them up into the boat and we were looking at them, and then he just pumped his fist in the air and he kind of almost ran a circle around the organisms and said, "I want to discover more things." And that really stuck with me as just a magical moment for him, and I think for the learning that he was doing.